Lenny here with Eyes on the Game, and I'm here being joined by former UFC heavyweight champion Fabricio Werdum. Now you're fighting Alistair Overeem for the third time, first time in the UFC. How have you been preparing for this fight?
Yeah, I have a good camp, you know, because the more important, I have an injury. This is very important for us, you know, because when I have an injury, maybe you know, training for 1 or 2 weeks, and this time nothing, zero, you know, little injuries, but nothing like
your eye, though?
No, it's okay. This is nothing. And I'm very happy about the next fight, you know. I know Overeem for a long time. I fought with him twice, and this is number 3. It's now 1-1, and the next Saturday, 2-1 for me.
What did you learn from the last time you fought him? I know it's been a while. It was when you guys were in Strikeforce.
Yeah, the Strikeforce, the first one is in Pride. I fought with him. I finished him the second round, the Kimura. I got his arm. And the second time is like a terrible fight, you know. It's like nobody liked the fight because I have an overtraining, and the fight is not go happen very, very well fight, you know. I pull the guard all the time because I don't have a power. I just pull the guard because this is my instinct, you know, because jiu-jitsu saved you. And the second time, like, is terrible, you know, but now I learn a lot, you know, have a lot of experience. This is a long time ago. And next Saturday, I want to show, I mean, I'm ready for this fight.
Now, would you kind of, or do you kind of feel that this is essentially kind of like a number one contender fight to fight Stipe once again?
Yes, in the rank, in the UFC rank, I'm number one, you know. And I think it's very important this fight, like a good fight, like a one good knockout or good submission. My next step is the title shot.
And I'm sure Stipe may be watching this fight. What are you hoping, like, what statement are you hoping to show him?
Yes, I don't want to show to him, you know. I just want to show my for my team, for me, for myself. And for sure I call him after then, you know, because I respect him, but I want my belt again.
What did you learn from that last fight against Stipe?
Yes, I learned a lot, you know. I lose my focus the fight week. In Brazil, in the stadium, 45,000 people there. I learned a lot, you know. I learned like a very important, you keep going, like the focus is very important, and I lose that.
So do you think that maybe essentially because you lost your focus that Stipe kind of got lucky there?
No, I don't say luck. It's so hard when I say luck for them. He's a good fighter too. He got a good punch, but I respect him. But next one, I think is in December, I think so. And I show like a different fight.
And also on UFC tonight, you mentioned some comments about, you know, Alistair being a bit smaller now and about orange juice. Yeah. Can you kind of, you know, elaborate on what you meant?
No, this is just like a joke, you know. He's like a big guy before, like a very huge guy. And now he's a Usada, you know, Usada very, going our home very, you know, big surprise, like a surprise test. And his body's changed, you know, but he's strong yet. This guy is a very dangerous fighter. He's a smart guy, have a lot of experience, and that's it.
And lastly, the big fight coming up, Mayweather and McGregor. Yes. What are your predictions and which round?
I think it's a good idea. I love the idea, you know, boxing versus MMA. And I think in the fight, you know, I think Mayweather beat him for sure. You know, he played with him, but the other side, like Conor McGregor, very smart guy. He win a lot of money, millions, you know. He promote this fight. I think this part he very intelligent, you know. But the other thing, Mayweather is the best.